Please, people, be careful for throwing stones in somebody's glass house. Don't make the same excuses over and over again. We have done it for centuries. Playing passive-aggressive and taking the victims out the scenario. Men have done it with women for centuries. Under the cruelty of Islam and of Christianity. Black Arabs have done it with Jews, and whites have done it in America and most of the West by blacks. Can we not stop with this psychotic behavior and extend compassion to all living beings? Evolve and go a vegan. Vegans are not the arrogant, self-entitled pricks who force their lifestyle onto others. The animals are sensuous and aware, and it is a shame that our law system still considers them to be nothing more than automatons, tools, brainless. This mindset, anthropocentrism, is outdated, delusional, and quite frankly insane. You know, whites in America also have done and think this way for centuries, for years, for times and times and times. About blacks and women were also considered to be less than a man. They were considered less rational, less complex, and more like beasts and mature than men. Don't come up with that asinine excuses for them. What about the workers? When literally any year more animals are executed than there ever have lived members of our own species. And for what reason? Taste pleasure? The males are castrated without anesthesia most of the time. The females are artificially inseminated. They are constant being impregnated. At least 70% of all the cows who come in the slaughterhouses or murder houses, the death camps, are pregnant. Why? Now, on the moment that the cow have given birth, the dairy industry again impregnates the cow. So constant let that milk flow go. Yes, cows, like all mammals, have a baby or are pregnant to give milk, to give mammal secretions. Their milk is made for their babies, like the breastfeed of your mother was made for you when you was a little one. Like dog milk is made for puppies and cat milk is made for kittens. You are not a baby cow. So stop stealing their baby's milk to satisfy your addiction of casomorphine, one opioid which reacts very similar and looks like very similar to morphine when it is in your body, you are consumed it. Don't come up with that asinine excuses from it is my right, animals are things. Have you ever Think about how that sounds. Law is not justice. You know, in Saudi Arabia, you can legally rape a child. Does that make it right, people? No fucking way. So, if you despise people who abuse children, why then make fun of ignoring the complete same innocence in the other animals, in the baby cows, in the baby piglets, the baby chickens, in the egg industry? Their life do also vulnerable to them. Their life just like you are your life, and your dog vulnerable his life, and the birds vulnerable their life that try to escape from danger. The lion, when the zebra is attacked by a lion, he does not say, this is my life, I am going to die. No, he tried to escape and run away. So, stop making excuses. Stop being asinine. Stop being an oppressive person. Cruelty is a choice. So is compassion. Why not choose the compassionate way? If you are a man, it does not make you less of a man if you are not cruel to other living beings. Actually, standing up against a systematic oppressive system is actually something to be proud of. It is something noble. It is something you show that you are not afraid to stand out. You are showing you are a strong person. You don't need approval of society. You don't have to be liked. That's something very powerful and very tough. If you can do that. True, strong woman and man don't need approval. They show the world how to live. They show the world how to be a better person. And they don't care about if it's been legal or not. They are caring about if it's been justifiable, if it's been logical, consistent, if it's been a duty to care about other living beings. Not because society told them that. If you understand what I mean. I hope so. Be the light. Be the torch. And look how the people are going to follow you. And follow in your steps. Be an inspiration. Change begins by one. Change begins or can begin now. The person you have been, you don't have to be. It's your choice. Are you staying apathetic to all the cruelty you're indirectly committing to the other earthlings and to the earth? We're going you to stand up. Don't be a hypocrite. Don't hate people who abuse dogs and cats and children, but loving and respecting people and say you're doing a good job when they abuse other animals. When you not can most likely even watch the footage of slaughterhouses or movies like Earthlings or Dominion and cry. This time if you ask me. To evolve, make a plea, and go vegan. Kindness begins on the dinner table, by what you eat on a daily basis. Compassion to all living beings is a mark of a civilized society. Cockfighting, rodeos, and zoos. Slaughterhouses, execution chambers, death camps, and barbaric, outdated vivisection laboratories. Along with cruel blood sports like hunting, enactments, and all kinds of death barbarity, are all signs of an uncivilized cult. Civilized people don't murder other living creatures just because they can. Good people stand up for other living beings, no matter the consequence, because they are not morally cowards. Good people say enough is enough. This will end now to the people who do the oppressing and say, if you are not stopped, you will be paid with your life. When darkness and light become one, the reality splintered away and the truth become invisible.